Hey guys, this is David Kwon, and I'm here to talk about my favorite character from Killzone, the first game. I really don't want to talk about Killzone 2 or Killzone 3, even though they're much more well-known, they're much more talked about in the gaming circles and whatnot. Killzone 1 is kind of always brushed aside and kind of, it's been forgotten about now. That's one of the reasons why I think it's interesting to talk about it. But the other reason is because if you were to ask me to pick a favorite character from Killzone 2 and or from Killzone 3, I would have a hard time of trying to pick which one. Not because there are many, but because almost all the characters in both games I don't care about or I hate. Rico Vasquez, I hate that character. Like, why Guerrilla Games decided to have that character be so prominent in Killzone 2. And then in Killzone 3, he's the only, like, side character that is throughout. Except for maybe the... Okay, no, that's not true. There's the other guys who I don't even remember the names of. See, that's what I mean. Like, Killzone 2 and Killzone 3 had such awful characters. It's like... It falls into the trap of being just another first-person shooter with really bland storytelling. I mean, don't get me wrong, the first few moments of Killzone 2 is story-wise, and just experiencing it-wise, amazing. But then, just the, you know, and it's ironic because I think Killzone 2 had the most powerful ending compared to Killzone 1 and Killzone 3. It's really weird because, to me, I see this trend in all three Killzone games. And even so in the Killzone Liberation, which is the PSP Killzone title. It's weird because in all Killzone games, it seems like they start out great. Killzone 1's opening cutscene, amazing stuff. They start out great. Killzone 1, up to like the halfway point, or a little after the halfway point, great stuff. And then after the halfway point, it's like, alright guys, we kind of forgot about what the story was, so here you go, play some levels. Oh, and then we're gonna wrap it up at the end with a betrayal you just saw, you saw coming from miles away that you predicted from like pretty much the beginning of the game. Betrayal happens. The end. Killzone 3. The great cohesive moments maybe in the beginning a little bit, and then it just goes all kinds of weird directions, and then the ending happens. Killzone 3's ending left me like, wait, what? What just happened? So it's just weird. Killzone 2's ending was the most powerful because it was a cliffhanger, and it was the most cohesive throughout, but the middle parts of Killzone 2's storytelling was just all over the place. Story-wise, these are messy stories, Killzone-wise. But characters-wise, Killzone 2 and Killzone 3, I'm not even going to do videos of them. I'm just going to pick Killzone 1 because I think Killzone 1, out of the trilogy, and this is including Killzone Liberation. Liberation didn't really have characters to choose. Killzone 1 had the strongest cast of characters compared to the three games, compared to the other Killzone games, which isn't saying much. It's not like Killzone 1 also has a lot of great, interesting characters. But there are two really interesting characters that I have a hard time, I think that are really cool. So Killzone 1 has four main playable characters. One is Rico Vasquez, whom I just hate so much. But one is Rico Vasquez. Sorry, mispronounced his name. I don't even care. I don't like that character. Rico Vasquez is one of them. And then the other character is Jen Templar, who you start out playing as. And Jen Templar doesn't really... I don't really care about him. I don't hate him, but I don't care about him. He's the very definition of the term generic. Yes, no personality. It's kind of bland. He might as well have been a voiceless, faceless character. I feel like Gordon Freeman from Half-Life has more character and personality than Templar. And Gordon Freeman doesn't even talk in his games, you know? And then there's the two characters, the two playable characters, who make it hard for me to choose which is my favorite. There is Marshall Luger. She's a female operative wearing, like, night vision goggles, very skinny and agile. Really cool character to play as. That's one of the main things I loved about Killzone is each character that you pick to play as, you know, you can play the level in totally different ways because of their different character traits and character abilities. which is really cool. But she is this cold-hearted, just merciless spy who's, you know, who likes, you know, sneaking in the dark and stabbing in the back. Pretty awesome stuff. And she always carries, like, silenced weapons. Really cool character, but not much backstory, which is why I have to pick Haka. That's my favorite character in Killzone 1. Okay, I think just this fact is interesting. Just this fact alone makes him easy choice to become my favorite character in the in Killzone, and possibly the entire Killzone universe. Because, like I said, Killzone 2 and Killzone 3 doesn't have very many interesting characters, except for one, which is Skolar Bisari. He's probably, if I had to pick a favorite character out of the two Killzone games, Killzone 2 and Killzone 3, it would have to, or Killzone 2, it would have to be Bisari. In Killzone 3, it would have to be Stahl, but barely. But Haka is half human, half Helgen. Holy shit. That fact alone just makes him so interesting. He has the most incredibly interesting and unique voice. His voice acting is robotic, but yet it's human, it's animal-like. I love it. I really love this character. He's very pragmatic. He causes tension with Rico, who is all anti-Helgen. That's kind of why I like Rico's role in Killzone 1. He made sense. It made sense to have this archetype of a character in Killzone 1's storyline, because you have someone like Haka. To have him continue, I don't know, it was a horrible story decision to have Rico be such a continued character and such a prominent character in the Killzone universe. But that aside, you know, Haka is very collected. He has a very composed manner about him. He's very calculating. One of his special abilities is to defuse bombs. That kind of tells you about his personality, of his technical abilities and his willingness to kind of come up with different strategies and tactics to tackle the problem. Really love about that. I think he's one of the most intelligent characters that are shown in the Killzone universe. Most characters in the Killzone universe are just dumb. Really dumb, trigger-happy characters. I would like to even say that about Lugar, who is really, you know, so merciless and so cold-hearted that she just is all about killing. I think Haka is one of the most moral and internally conflicted characters in the Killzone universe, which is why I pick him as my favorite, because those are the kind of characters that I'm always drawn into, the characters that have internal struggles within themselves. And Haka is definitely an embodiment of that. It's really disappointing to me how all three Killzone games so vilify the Helgens. I feel like they could go on a totally different route with their storytelling, especially when their opening scenes are speeches from, like, Skolar Bisari or from Stahl, from the Helgen perspective, you know, and you kind of are made to resonate with the Helgens. But when you actually play the game, they're just villains that you just kill. I feel like the Helgens, they should have more personality in the gameplay as well, in the Killzone universe. That would make the games really strong, I think. I mean, I love Killzone. Killzone 2 and Killzone 3 are, like, one of my most favorite first-person shooters because of gameplay. Story-wise, it's just a complete mess. Characters-wise, I don't even want to talk about it. You know, Killzone 1 is the only one I want to talk about when it comes to characters. But, you know, I feel like that's a shame. Killzone has such a rich universe. I think it would be, you know, you could make a novel out of the Killzone universe, and those would be amazing books, I feel like. You know, as great as Halo books. Or it might be even better because of you know, the poignancy of the universe, and the Civil War, and the parallel you could draw with World War II and racism and genocide and all that. It's a rich universe. But then they made it into games, and their stories are complete crap. That's when I have a problem with it. Killzone 1, you know, story was kind of just but at least the characters were pretty awesome. And, you know, I really wish the future Killzone games don't take the route of Killzone 2 and Killzone 3 in terms of story. But it feels like they're going to do that. But, yeah, those are just my two thoughts. my comment, my question, I guess, at the end of the video is, I don't know, just a random question. Do you think it's possible that they could bring Haka into the future Killzone game as a character, or Lugar as a character? Wouldn't that be awesome if Killzone Shadowfall featured at some point Haka or Lugar? Lugar, I don't even know how to pronounce her name, but wouldn't that be awesome? Tell me your thoughts, comment, whatever. But yeah, that's my video. Next video, I'll talk about a female character. Haven't decided which game to pick, but